Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the last day of live web streaming coverage of the 5th Annual Columbus Classic 2016. It's a GLTA Master Series event here at the Wickertree Tennis Club in Columbus, Ohio, brought to you by the CCE Sports Network, where diversity lives. We're traveling around the country bringing you the best in club, amateur, and semi-professional sports. This is our fourth year here at the Columbus Classic, and we're happy to celebrate our fifth anniversary year with the folks over at the CMTO who are running the Columbus Classic, who are celebrating their fifth year as well. As you know, the CCE Sports Network is supported by viewers like yourself and by the generous donations of our sponsors. So I want to take a quick moment to thank our sponsors who have always been a part of this broadcast. Directional Boar, 4 years in a row, they have sponsored the live web stream broadcast, so we want to thank them. They're the leader in the underground utility construction industry, providing services throughout the Midwest. Directional Boar is working with utility companies to replace aging underground gas, electric, water, and sewer infrastructure, as well as constructing a new fiber infrastructure to support the ever-increasing demands for technology. Learn more by visiting their website at Directional Boar LLC. We also want to thank Union Cafe and Access Nightclub. They're the premier entertainment destination in Columbus's Short North District. Go out and enjoy a delicious lunch, dinner, or drink off of their menu at the Union Cafe, then dance night away or catch a fabulous show over at Access Nightclub, unioncafe.com. We want to thank our newest sponsor to the live web streaming broadcast, Parallel Financial, and the folks over there. We also want to thank BJ White over at Core Ohio Realty and their newest division, Confluence Home Partners, leading realtors here in the Metropolitan Columbus area at coreohio.com. And finally, the folks who provide lodging for the tennis players and for the CC Sports Network, Cambria Suites at Polaris. Fantastic property. Learn more at CambriaSuitesPolaris.com. So as always, we're joined, not always, but it's good that we're joined with a guest commentary. Go ahead and introduce yourself to everybody.
Hi, I'm Brandon Walker. I'm one of the CMTO members. Played the inaugural Columbus Classic 5 years ago, and so it's I'm excited to be here for our first...
first match of the day, really?
Yeah, it was first match for me, being able to watch, and looks like we have a great final here.
So this is the Open Division Finals, the number one seed Kenny Evans versus Robbie Kao, and Robbie is serving first.
First year of us having a master as well.
Yes, and I wanted to congratulate you guys for an outstanding job getting the GLTA Master Series designation, double points for the winners in the race up to the GLTA Championship in February in Orlando.
A great turnout this weekend.
137 players. That is just outrageous. Outrageous. We'll get caught up on the scores in a second. I got all my administrative tasks done. So Kenny has been on our show court. They've both been on our show courts before. Kenny won the Alamo City Classic in San Antonio, Texas, so we got to see that win with him. Mm-hmm. Robbie's been on our court, so he's no stranger to the CC Sports Network. Both excellent players. Yesterday?
Oh my goodness. Robbie's already having grip issues there. I see him looking down his hand and wiping his hand. It's so humid down there, it's hard to control the racket and hold on to it. It's almost 80 degrees this morning. My first ball.
And we're at 30 all.
Robbie.
And answers with a great backhand.
Absolutely. 1-2 punch.
Got to be nice when you have a plan and you execute it and it works flawlessly for you.
Absolutely.
Great confidence booster. Robbie holds. One game to love. So you play any tournaments coming up?
I think I'll play one towards the end of August.
Okay.
It's a small little tournament that we have here in the city. And I haven't been able to play a lot. Busy work schedule.
Yeah, that's tough. You know, that whole working thing, paying the bills. Jeez. Who wants to do that stuff?
So I have not had a great season, unfortunately, for the spring, summer. Always interesting coming into a final in an open at that. When it comes to nerves.
Mm-hmm.
Second serve.
You think Kenny's got some nerves?
I think so. A couple of balls dumped into the net. Body language doesn't seem.
And it's early. I guess sometimes you have to just kind of warm yourself up. And they did a fast warm-up, too,
I
noticed.
Yep. So it takes a little bit to get body loose and things like that. You know, Kenny's tall. So it can get the, takes a little bit to get those joints to the mic.
Yeah, those last two serves, he settled down. There.
Exactly. Getting a little bit more confident, comfortable on the court. Ooh, nice hold. One all. I think for both players holding your first services, that's going to relax them, and so they'll be able to go out on their shots and hit through the ball.
You know, Robbie's got an interesting ball toss. Have you ever, like, really looked at his ball toss? Kind of like, I don't know how to describe it. It just looks a little different, but it works for him.
Absolutely. But I think for the player, you're not sure exactly what direction he's going to go.
Maybe that's what it is that strikes me.
Mm-hmm. Ready for that out wide. Returned it ball back with interest.
So how did Kenny get to the finals?
We had a first round bye, then a three-setter. First two sets were tight, and then he just pulled away in that second round match.
That was James Tomasino. Then went on to play Ross Bushi, the number three seed.
Yeah, I got a retirement.
Yep. Yeah, he was cramping really bad. That's what I heard. He was, because we caught his doubles match afterwards, which he was fine, but apparently he was cramping really, really bad in that singles match. And then he moved on to here.
And I stand corrected with Tomasino. It was a tough first set, tie break, and then.
And then blew him away in the second set.
Second set, 6-1.
Robbie Kale did not have a bye, so he played Garnett Taylor. Won that 6-2, 7-6. Went on to play the number two seed, Trevor Cox. And he had to take three sets on Trevor, 6-2, 1-6. Ooh, really fell in the second set, but then came back 6-4. Raul Mendez, he played. Defeated him pretty handily, 6-4, 6-1, to move on to the finals.
So it looks like Robbie's had more matches and more time on the court.
And one more match. And it looks like his draw was harder.
But that always can groove you for a final.
Yeah, it looks like maybe it looks like they're going to play that point again. They stopped play for some reason, but I can't determine why.
Maybe ball from the other court. Let.
Punishing forehand.
No mistake about that for him. You know, playing difficult matches like that, you start to peak at the right time. Looks like both men are in form.
Another punishing, yeah.
These courts reward the aggressive player.
Yeah, they are fast.
Well, flat gets the court, stays low.
Enjoy the banquet last night? You didn't make it. Yeah, it was nice. Raised $8,000 for Buddy Tennis, Buddy Up Tennis. So.
Everybody's in the banquet before now and I was resting.
Robbie's doing a good job of pulling Kenny off the court and forcing him into errors.
I'd like to see Kenny reposition himself and anticipate that out-wide serve force down the tee. In return, you have to give your opponent different looks. Force them to come up with something different. Right now, Robbie's really grooved with that out wide serve.
So. What's a good answer for Kenny if he keeps that up? Like, how can Kenny stay in the point if he keeps getting pulled off the court? Like, how would you respond to that?
Well, you have to anticipate the serve. Once you see that the servers keep going to one service shot, you basically stand over there and wait for the serve to go there. Send it back with interest. Usually get it right at the feet, so then there's you just can block it back, and then you can
time
come
to get
in.
Back in position.
Absolutely. Try to hit a high ball. Give yourself time.
Yeah, and that's what I was alluding at. That you get so pulled off the court that it's the biggest worry, that you don't have enough time to get back. And then
you gotta knock your opponent off their rhythm. Robbie's in a great rhythm right now. I'm gonna put doubt in his head. Kenny's gotta get the ball out of the middle of the court. It's allowing Robbie to dictate. He's gotta move the ball around. Easier said than done, though.
I couldn't do it. So as you guys know, when we do the open matches, I often don't stay on top of the scores. I only do the game scores. The open players love them, but they never call their scores out. And then sometimes the calls are different on the court than they are when I see them up here. So I usually just stick to the game scores. So if you're wondering why I'm not putting the individual scores, that's why. I'm not slacking on the job. Too early to get tired and forgetful. Nice return.
Kenny was in control there. He was doing to Robbie what's been done to him, is keeping him moving and off balance.
He's looking a little winded.
Yeah, he is. Came out strong. Had to come out too fast. If you're Kenny at this point, you just gotta stay with Robbie, hold, serve, and wait for your opportunity. Because I know the temperature up here is is something special, so I can only imagine down on a court with conditions that are even heavier. It's probably windy. Humid. he's getting a little noisy. Serve to spin it in, especially it throws your opponent off when you've been going a little bit more for your serve and you take a little bit off. Kenny didn't move his feet to get up to that ball. Dump it into the net.
The funny thing is that last ball was long and Kenny didn't call it.
Exactly. Yeah.
Gives Robbie a break.
Sometimes you even think in your back of your mind, is that ball in or was it out? And when you lose the point, you kind of think back to that. And you gotta have memory and just let it go.
Right. Robbie KO holds serve. The players are on serve. 2-1. Back in a quick moment.
Vikings. Red State. Blue State.
We come from different places.
Uptown.
But
downtown.
When we live united, we create real lasting change in the education, income, and health of our
live
country.
United.
Real change won't happen without you. So give, advocate, volunteer. Live United. Sign up at liveunited.org.
We're back live here at the Wickertree Tennis Club. Court number 5 for the Open Finals Championship. The number 1 seed, Kenny Evans. He's going to be serving at the top of your screen. Robbie KO. Players on serve. That last game was a long one. It's almost 12 minutes long.
It was.
The players have been on the court for about 25 minutes. About 22 minutes. We've only gone through 3 games.
Brutal. Deep ball.
Mm-hmm.
It took time away from Robbie.
Oh. Ooh. I know Kenny is mad at himself for that one. Beautiful.
Just going to say, I noticed Robbie doesn't give a lot of time in between points. He just gets right back up to the line. And sometimes you want to give yourself a little bit of time to reset. Just a couple moments, just reset and game plan.
Yeah, we mentioned that yesterday, me and Doyleen, in one of the previous matches with the Atlanta guys.
Robbie.
They were moving so quickly, point after point, even though the they didn't have what's the word I'm looking for? The rhythm on their side.
Mm-hmm.
Is that that Mark Buckingham character over there? Mark Buckingham, the tournament director.
Did a fabulous job this year, as always.
I tell you what, I don't envy the tournament directors. They do so much work to put these things on.
Putting pressure on serve. Can he serve?
Got the break.
Even though we thought Robbie was a little winded.
I guess not, huh?
No.
Dug down a little deep, found something.
Yeah. He's finding extra gears. Joined by last year's winner.
Yeah, and our tourney director for Cincy, Queen City. Yes. We're coming up there to do his tournament. So excited. It'll be our first stop, first time in Cincinnati.
Yeah. Jeff Morganson.
Oh, no problem. Don't even worry about it.
Robbie's having his way with Kenny at the moment.
Okay, so you're Kenny's coach, but what'd you tell him?
I would say calm down and get more aggressive. He needs to dictate because Robbie right now is dictating play. He has to be able to step in on the baseline. He's too far back, and he's doing a lot of scrambling and running and allowing Robbie to set up his shots. Maybe even think about coming in on some of the deep balls.
Just to give Robbie a different look.
Absolutely. Got to switch things up, take him out of his rhythm.
Would you change anything with Robbie's gameplay? Is he going to the well too much?
I don't think at the moment, but I would like to see him mix up the serve. You know, it's becoming predictable, but if it's working, you know, why switch it
yeah, right.
if it's working? Court over. I wonder if that threw Robbie off a little bit.
Yeah, I heard that, and just for a split second. Oh my God, that's the first time someone's called a score. I always tease these guys.
Say it louder.
Help a brother out. Thank you.
that was exactly the point that Kenny should be playing. He stood on the baseline, nice forehand, set it up, the cross court, hit Robbie on a run.
Puts him in a position now to get his break back.
Maybe he heard me.
Osmosis from the booth. And he gets the break.
Yep. It's all about being aggressive, standing on that baseline. And, you know, Kenny is pretty tall, so he can really take it to Robbie, and especially on these courts, where the courts, the ball, you hit flat and aggressive, it stays low. So your opponent either has to bend down low or they are going to hit a defensive shot, and it gets you into position to do something with the ball.
Let's take a quick break. You're watching live web streaming coverage of the Open Finals, the Columbus Classic 2016.
Hart, what's going on?
I'm leaving.
Why? What did I do?
Not enough. You constantly ignore me. You barely eat anything healthy. You're half as active as you used to be. The pressure is just too much. I quit.
Okay, I get it. I'll do better. Just please, don't leave.
Okay, but remember, if I go, you go.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
Two quick points here for Kenny to start off the game.
Make that three. Maybe Kenny can settle down here after getting that break back. Up on his serve, 40 love.
Easy game there for Kenny Evans, the number one seed. We're even at three games apiece. Sometimes it's nice just to have an easy game.
It does. Settles you, relaxes, gets butterflies out. Kenny to try to create an opportunity to get another break. I don't think he anticipated it was going to come right at him.
Sail it wide, but Kenny kept it in play.
Mm-hmm. Do you think Robbie looks a little winded again?
No. Although I think he looks a little disappointed after having lost that break. I think the momentum, that's the word I was looking for earlier, momentum. The momentum is gone.
Yep.
And the question is going to be, can he capitalize on this?
Mm-hmm.
He's taking his time, though. I will give it to him. Getting a little water, doing the towel. He's taking the full advantage of the 30 seconds.
Absolutely. And that's what you got to do. You want to have quick, you know, amnesia to the last game and, you know, recollect your thoughts and refocus. Push the reset button and stick to your game. Task at hand.
You can really take a player who likes to be fast and aggressive out of his game by being slow and deliberate.
Absolutely. Takes them out of their rhythm.
Nice. Mm,
nice put away there. And that's what I expect to see more from Kenny in this match, is to be able to come in and put the ball away. He doesn't want to get into long rallies with Robbie, because it looks like Robbie has the edge in long rallies at the moment. Beautiful. Ute. That's what you call using your opponent's speed there.
Robbie KO up 4-3 on the number one seed, Kenny Evans. You know, I don't think Kenny has sat down this whole entire match, has he?
I don't think so. You know, that could be a sign of just a lot of things going on in your mind, nerves, or it could be, you know, just keeping the body loose.
Mm-hmm.
But as we see, he's a fast player, so he likes to push through.
And in all fairness, most of the open players are like that. Most of the time when I cover an open match, I don't see open players doing what Robbie's doing, just really just...
Taking the time.
Most of the open guys are just boom, 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 boom. Let's just keep this stuff moving.
And, you know, if you're used to that and somebody isn't, then that can really take you out of your rhythm. Kenny's right there waiting.
Just like
he's ready patiently.
Like, come on. We see that muttering Kenny.
Absolutely. And, you know, that can be the strategy. You know, very strategic and deliberate for Robbie. And it looks to be agitating. He's got to let it go.
And the thing is, Robbie's not breaking the rules.
No.
No, he's allowed this time.
And I think as a player, you have to adjust to it. And if you're Robbie, you're noticing what's going on the other side of the court. So that's going to, you know, boost his confidence. And when you see your opponent rattle like that. Now we have Robbie muttering.
Thank you. Wow. I actually thought that was going to go long.
I did, too. Put spin on it. Dropped in right on the line. But he hit behind Kenny. Even though Kenny won that point, I would have liked to see him come in behind the shot, keep moving forward.
Robbie with a break.
Great point.
That had cleared the net. I think he had a winner on his hands.
As a player, when you leave a ball in the court, middle of the court like that, you know that's frustration.
Says, oh my God.
He's stuck in area now. Did a lot of running there.
He did get the break though.
Yes.
He can serve for the first set.
Yes, he's going to take a minute to regroup. Still hear him sucking in air for that one. First player to solidify the break.
Was that?
The first player to solidify
yep.
the break.
Mm-hmm.
Robbie serving 5-3. He's got to be aggressive on his second serve. Force the issue.
Ball traveled over the court number 7. Six, rather. He didn't go down that far.
Court 6, they have a few coolers over there.
I don't blame them. I do not blame them. Nice. Serve or nope.
Looks like it was false.
Yep.
Wrong. Oh, beautiful. Stepped in on that forehand. Forehand winner. Love 30.
out of the air.
Right. That's what you have to do. You have to be aggressive. Come in behind your shot, especially if you get your opponent out wide. Don't give them opportunity to get back in the point. Take time away. Especially when you're serving for it.
Beautiful serve.
And he had the shot and he had the open court. Sometimes it's those easy shots that gives you the most trouble. We're at 30 all. Robbie's taking a moment here. It's some air. You know, in that point, Kenny played smart. He gave himself a lot of depth, a lot of height over the net, which allowed him to stay in position and cause Robbie to do a lot of running. Kenny with a break point to get back on serve. Robbie, you want to slow it down just a little bit. Nice deep breath there.
It's like, is it over yet? Kenny gets the break back.
That's when you know a person's a little bit winded and tired. They try to go for too much too soon. Try to needle it down the line.
Good, good, good. Mr. South Florida Tennis Club, John Hardy, coming by the booth. So up next for the CC Sports Network, we are headed to, if everything goes as expected, on August 8th to the IGLFA World Soccer Championship, 22nd Annual World Soccer Championship in Portland, Oregon. That broadcast will start on August the 8th and run to the 13th, so a long week of soccer. Oh my God, I can't even talk. A long week of soccer. Then next up on the tennis circuit, August 26th through the 28th, we head to Cincinnati, Ohio for Queen City Open 2016. And then following that, hopefully, I haven't got the confirmation yet, but hopefully we'll be returning to Washington, D.C. for a fourth year in a row for the Cap Classic.
Cincinnati should be another hot one.
But I hear I get to be on the stadium court for the live broadcast, so I'm kind of excited about that.
That's really exciting. Yeah. And then hopefully you'll be inside.
Hopefully I'll be covered. Yeah. So if that unexpected Midwest rain that you all get that drive me freaking crazy, and that's why I hate trying to be outside in the Midwest, won't get me. But I have not seen the stadium, so I don't know what it looks like.
It's a beautiful facility. That's where WTA and ATP, one of the big events of the U.S. Open Series at the Western Southern Open.
Oh, okay.
And I do media there, so I'm always sitting in the photo pit, and it's like excruciating. So I guess I really can't complain about the conditions here.
Right.
I'll be there in a few weeks covering the Western Southern Open. And some notable players missing from that, though, the Williams sisters, you know, they'll be at the Olympics, and but they still have a good roster.
Yeah, as long as I have a place to put Video Village and then just stick my cameras out there, as long as I got something over my head, I'll be fine.
Oh, yeah, you'll be good.
You know, the big boys over at ESPN got the nice 150-foot, 75-foot truck
exactly.
behind the stadiums.
Absolutely.
I am not that big. I just got my two little 6-foot tables. I got enough equipment on the 6-foot tables, but that's about it.
Wicked forehand. But it works for you.
No, and the good thing is it makes it very mobile for us, so that way I can, it's easy for me to travel from tournament to tournament and city to city. And then it's just up to the individual tournaments to come up with the budgets on how we, you know, how we staff the production side of it. Mm-hmm. You know, where we have multiple camera people, or we have dedicated graphics people, or, you know, we have regular, you know, color commentators, you know, for every day. Like in soccer, we'll have, you know, we'll have a couple of camera operators. We'll have two play-by-play people for the whole entire tournament, you know, so they'll be the voice of the tournament for the entire tournament.
We had a hold here, so it's 5-all. Kenny's number one seat for a reason. And that's what I expected from Kenny, is to be able to come in and be aggressive.
He hasn't done it too often, but when he has, he's won the point.
Mm-hmm. Very effective, especially on these courts.
Almost.
Went for it,
yeah.
Right?
And even though you miss it, sometimes you can't fault yourself for trying because it was the right opportunity at the right time.
Absolutely. And that sends a message on the other side of the court that anything slow coming,
you're gonna punish it. Yeah.
Absolutely. Try to cause the server to put a little extra on it.
I think I heard him say 15-all.
Sets up nicely for the forehand.
Yeah, and he had to smile for that because he knew that was a nice shot.
Yes.
Give yourself a pat on the back.
Steady the pace and remain aggressive. Look for opportunity. Oh, goodness. He is really finding the mark there. I think I just heard Kenny say, how does he keep doing that?
Same spot.
Down.
Yep, same spot, gutsy, same shot. Gutsy. Look at you smiling. Robbie's like, I got you twice.
A few times. That's 1-2 punch.
This guy's been at it for 55 minutes. Still in the first set.
Very humid conditions.
Yeah, you can look at Robbie's shirt. And he's just totally drenched almost from head to toe. Mm-hmm. Oh,
wow, on a backhand side.
Damn. Robbie, you made me curse on air. You made me do a damn. It was just three punishing, brutal shots
Fingers.
In this.
Absolutely.
6-5.
Still on serve. Yep. Being at this, the way they're playing, I'd like to see this play out in a tiebreak.
Who would you give the edge to in a tiebreaker? Tough one, I know.
It is a tough one. Right now, as far as confidence, Robbie seems to be more confident at the moment, really going for his shots than Kenny. But, again, number one seed for a reason. We've been in, you know, face adversity in these kind of conditions before, in these pressure point moments.
Like, well, just let me just watch what's going on the other match on the other court.
You know, sometimes you can pull confidence and pull strategy from watching other players. You can relax, you take your mind off of it just for a moment. Kenny, excuse me, at the line, ready to go. Can you move the ball around a lot there?
Yeah, something you mentioned earlier.
Move the ball around. Get your opponent on a run. Dictate.
And he immediately moved into that next serve.
Mm-hmm.
Worked for him.
It's really good out wide serve. think Kenny's doing a good job of mixing up the serve. That was one other one right off the line. Nice hole. We're at where I thought we should be at a tie break.
Yep.
Both men have faced a tie break, I believe, in this tournament. It's all about who's going to be aggressive. Not the way Robbie wanted to start off?
No, not at all.
Topsy-turvy so far. Mini break.
This time Robbie made it all the way down to court 7.
Robbie trying to pump himself up. Thank you. back net point. Wasn't able to stand on the line.
Yeah, these guys are determined to make this a 3-hour match. But they're that tightly matched, so.
Mm-hmm.
Job there from Kenny.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Set up with that big forehand.
Robbie said, I didn't know there was something back there. Kenny said, yeah, it's a wall.
Business with that serve.
Yes, he did. Homeboy said, yeah, it's a wall.
And he's serving for the set.
Almost. And we got the grunt, too, because he was going to give us the grunt winner.
Exactly, yeah. He smiled after that. Comes through, snuck out that set.
And it's funny too, because you would think the momentum favored Robbie for most of the match, and Kenny just quietly stayed in it.
And that's what you do, you just stay with the opponent, and like I said, you just wait for that opportunity. And again, you know, being a number one seed, you've been facing these conditions before. Mm-hmm. And so you just rely on your experience and just hang in there with your opponent and seize the moment. And that's what Kenny did, seize the moment.
We'll be starting the second set in a moment. You're watching the Open Championship Finals here. The number one seed, Kenny Evans versus Robbie Kao at the Wickertree Tennis Club, Columbus, Ohio. Back in a moment. Guys wasted no time in starting the second set.
Mm-hmm.
forget the 3-minute rest period. They started immediately.
And again, Kenny did not have a seat.
I don't know how the boy does it.
See that Robbie hasn't come out to have a letdown after that. Still fighting. Court winner. Definitely the start that Robbie won it. Looks like we have some equipment issue going on here. I think Kenny was complaining about not having grip.
Yep.
And
it seems so deceiving. Once again, it seems like Robbie has the momentum, mm-hmm. but Kenny hangs in there. at every point. And quietly just walks away.
Junior player. Probably going to the towel, taking a moment. Game point. Blistering forehand.
Protects his break. 2 games to love.
Look for Kenny to regroup and impose himself. Anytime that you win a tight set like that, going to the next set, or whoever the winner is of that first set, could take you a game or two to get it back up there, get your level back up. Change up. Slice.
And he can only shake his head.
Punished.
That's when you put your hand on your hip and you say, damn.
Great point for Robbie. Go up 3, love. Looks like there's some assistance here going on with the rip.
Oh.
Can he hang in there to get it back to Deuce? Excellent point. I think both men will take a moment to get back up to the line. His was bad.
I was going to say, his grunts went up an octave.
A couple of octaves there. Wow. Second serve break point. Looks like we have grip coming off of the racket of Kenny. Doesn't want to take too much time between service. Oh boy. Second serve, break point.
At his racket. Yeah, his serve seemed a little tentative once he took that grip off. Mm-hmm. You know,
it's difficult to break the rhythm between the first and second serve.
Let's take a quick break. You're watching live web streaming coverage of the Columbus Classic 2016. So we were commenting on Kenny's racket wrapping technique.
He'll be up pretty low.
But at least he got it back wrapped, so.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the important thing.
Absolutely.
Of course, I had always had somebody wrap my racket because I didn't know what the hell I was doing. They're like, Thomas, stop it. Thomas, stop it. All right, fine. I admit, I'm clueless. So they've been on the court an hour and 25 minutes.
Mm-hmm. I'm tired looking at them. I'm tired for them. Great competition.
Yeah, and open finals always tend to be, and this one is no exception. Mm-hmm. Love 30.
What an opportunity for Kenny. Get back into the set. Three break points. Oh, that was excellent.
Beautiful serve.
Robbie keeping himself engaged in the match. Two more break points. Points saved.
Is Kenny's in the doubles final? Do you know?
I don't know.
I'll take a look at the... Look. No. Mm.
Kenny gets a break.
Let's take a look and see. And nope, it's Trevor Cox and Gorman Long.
Kenny's starting to turn it on now.
Like that, Robbie erased every break point. mean, not break point, service hold.
Ooh. Wicked return.
Robbie is on fire here in the second set.
Second serve. And back to deuce. Robbie back to the tower. A couple breaths of air.
Oh my God,
Kenny did everything to stay into that point.
Oh dear.
Of course.
Second serve. Able to hold. Two, three, Robbie still up a break. Thank you.
all the singles championships are going on. None of them have wrapped up yet. I'm assuming these are all singles champions down here on the other courts.
I think there
were finals. Was there a couple of semis today?
Still going out. I thought, oh, those poor people. Joined by Dwayne Williams. I think that was wide. He's looking to create opportunity to get back on serve.
That quiet move in.
Mm-hmm. Very stoic. Sets himself up with that return. Gives him 3 break points.
Do it to you.
Robbie saves one break point, still 2 break points for Kenny. That second serve. Probably thanking the tennis gods. Doing an excellent job on saving break points. We've seen this earlier. Still break point for Kenny to get back on serve. A little friendly exchange of words at the net. Point saved. Deuce. Looks like court 6 wrapped up. I believe that was a final. That's the first singles match wrap up. just like that, and race three, break points. Now, point to go up 4-2. Escaped. Able to hold. We're at 4-2, second set. Kenny took the first set. Tie break. Just a little frustration. These balls are awfully close to being out.
I thought that one's out.
Mm-hmm. All right, 15 all. Want to give opportunity for Robbie to serve out the set. Oh, that's how you answer it. Game point for Kenny.
Robbie still up a break, 4-3. Well, Robbie KO serving here in the second set.
Ooh. Right on the line. Where I'm sweating. Double fault. It's more of a brain cramp, double fault. It's difficult to go that fine out wide on a second serve, especially when you're up 4-3. Kenny to make a move here. Hmm. 15-30. Wonderful opportunity for Kenny. But in a clutch moments, we've seen Robbie come up with some big shots.
Yes.
Big forehands. Out.
Yeah, he didn't call it.
Yeah.
But he was lucky because Rob put it in the net.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
It looked like it was a put out. There's a few balls that I would have thought Kenny would have called. It was close.
Got the break.
Yeah, back on serve. I saw this in the second, the first set.
Mm-hmm.
Just when you thought Robbie was going to pull away, Kenny was able to sneak back in. Robbie did give him a few easy points, an opportunity to get back into the second set. Kenny right to the line, ready to go.
Thank you.
set him on a yo-yo.
That was a nice change-up, though.
It was. But it looks like Kenny, I think he probably is starting to taste the finish line here and start to really move that ball around and get Robbie moving on a run. Maybe put more spin on it instead of trying to drive the ball. Kenny's doing a good job of moving the ball around.
Yes, he is.
Excellent serve. Regaining points, about 5-4.
Kenny holds. We're on serve. 5-4 here in the second set. You're watching live web streaming coverage of the Columbus Classic here at the Wickertree Tennis Club. Back in a quick moment.
Hart, what's going on?
I'm leaving.
Why? What did I do?
Not enough. Constantly ignore me. You barely eat anything healthy. You're half as active as you used to be. The pressure is just too much. I quit.
Okay, I get it. I'll do better. Just please, don't leave.
Okay, but remember, if I go, you go.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat. Ugly.
Disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
How's that for timing?
Perfect, excellent timing, just to watch Kenny win the first point. You're Robbie, you got to be clutch here. Kenny, you know, just won a tournament earlier this year.
Alamo City, yeah. He was on our show court, beat Coach Rob Amir from Houston. He retired from an injury, so he, after the first set, I believe. So, Kenny took the match.
Yeah. In or out?
35.
Okay. Didn't get up to the ball. Might have been those knees. Robbie trying to hold on. It's 5-5.
Was long, no, but he didn't call it.
Oh.
I think so.
That would be suitable. A little bit of time, going for the towel. A little bit more time for Kenny to think about where he's going to serve.
Unbelievable shot.
We send out all match from Robbie. Nice pickup. Tension rising. Robbie's heading for the fences.
To your other left.
Tension rising. Business part of the set.
What Kenny did not want.
Fight. Okay, here, Robbie putting everything into those shots. Get the break.
Robbie
opportunity to serve for it.
Yep, Robbie can serve for the second set. live web streaming coverage of the Columbus Classic 2016, a GLTA Master Series event. Back in a quick second.
Packers,
Vikings,
Red State, Blue State.
We come from different places.
Uptown.
But when we live united, we create real lasting change in the education, income, and health of our country. Real change won't happen without you. So give, advocate, volunteer, live unite. Sign up at liveunited.org.
Back live here at the Wickertree Tennis Club, Columbus, Ohio, for the championship finals of the open division between the number one seed Kenny Evans and Robbie Kayo. Players have been on court for 2 hours and 3 minutes.
Still in the second set.
Yes, it's still in the second set.
Very entertaining second set.
I was like, they want to see a third set.
I think Kenny has something to say about that. Big forehand. This is what we saw in the first set.
He had a break. Did he break back?
I think he broke back to take them to a tiebreak.
Okay.
It's been a few breaks.
I know, right?
Mark. Ooh. Big forehand is set up. Three break points. Take it to a tie break. Only fitting to go into a tie break.
Yeah, you're right. This is true.
It's been a battle out here. And we're in another tie break, 6-6. Now, I think that from what I've seen during this match, I think Kenny, this is when Kenny steps it up. Point exactly. This is when you go ahead and take it up a couple of gears. Mm-hmm. You do not want to go into the third set.
Yeah, I was kind of I was surprised at the shot selection.
Right, hit it right back to him. Robbie was there to stab it.
Somebody asked him, did he want some water? He said, no.
No.
He doesn't want no water. He doesn't want to sit down.
He wants to get this tiebreak over with. One all. I think we can feel the tension up here.
In the peanut gallery.
No, that was good quality last year.
So the players are taking a quick break. We're going to take a quick break. Back in a moment.
Serving a tie break. Both men to the break. We try to be aggressive on the return. On serve. Side out forehand winner. 3-all. Robbie showing a lot of fight in this tie break.
Yeah.
4-3. Kenny serving.
You guys are wondering what we're talking about. Jeff, the tournament director for Queen City, the facility he's using wants to charge him $2,500 to have access to the locker rooms and showers, which is more than the rental of the court facility.
Maybe it comes with a $10. Ooh, beautiful. Oh, yeah. Fantastic shot. Puts Kenny 2 points in victory. Yeah, that must be some kind of facility. But, you know, they just it's a beautiful facility, and so I know that they're trying to make their money back.
Well, you want to hear something else. The USTA, and if I wanted to go to Liberty Open to film, they wanted to charge me $25,000 per day to bring my little 2 6-foot tables on there to film.
Oh, boy.
Like, sorry, guys. Not going to happen.
Caught that one out.
That's why we'll never go to the Liberty Open. And then the guy was telling me he was doing me a favor. I said, gee, thanks.
Oh, thanks.
I said, dude, I am not ESPN.
No. We don't have sponsors like that.
I'd like to have sponsors like that. Hint, hint, wink, wink, sponsors out there.
Tiebreak. Robbie serving.
It's that old man walk. Mm-hmm. And I'm tired of this shit.
We've seen this early on in the first set. We know he has different gears he can tap into.
Yeah. 2 hours, 15 minutes on the court so far. Mm-hmm. Sure enough. Does pull another year out.
Ooh. Robbie with a set point. The crowd has picked up over here.
Everybody knows it's a good match.
Pounding. Understandably, frustration from Robbie.
Come on, Robbie.
Tension building. Kenny has it on this one. He went back to moving the ball around. That Robbie out of position. Match point for Kenny. Match point number one. Match point. Championship point. Second serve, championship point.
Oh,
Game, set, match. Fitting two tie breaks.
I think it was very a very fitting in.
Nice embrace at the net.
Congratulations to the number one seed, Kenny Evans. He walks away with the Open's Finals Championship here at the Columbus Classic 2016, hosted by the Columbus Metropolitan Tennis Organization, brought to you by the CCE Sports Network, where diversity lives. It looks like we'll get a doubles finals. We'll see which one graces our court next, so don't go anywhere. We got at least one more fantastic tennis match in store for you. Thanks for watching. Be back in a moment.